wheel of my van, following a Supra. This is a very early one that you're looking at here. A restoration project. Jeez, look at that smoke. An engine or a boiler and a firebox. I should explain that it's a car that was built before unleaded petrol, obviously, and it's not got a fuel cap system in it to process the unleaded petrol. I expect this E10 is really not good for it. So. And it's a bloody big engine, 2.8 litre straight six. Been in this car that I'm following. It's all right, but it doesn't sound like a Japanese car. It sounds more like an American car, you know, because of the way it's misfiring and the way it's shaking all the time. So I don't think Toyota ever intended the coupes to. Behave like a Buick Riviera, but anyhow, I'm just an amateur. You can't smell this video as well as watch it, because jeez, I'd be getting sued for polluting, for causing asthmatic attacks. lovely day for cruising around the country lights. It's very pleasant.
On the
right in front of us, that's where you turn off for Warburton and the toll bridge. There you go. That was my coverage of following a 1984 Toyota Celica Supra. Sorry if it was a bit bland, but anyhow. I will see you in the next one. Bye.